Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be solving two very interesting problems based on Friis Transmission Formula. If you see these two questions, then that is based on Friis Transmission Formula. If you have seen my last two videos, one is based on Friis Transmission Formula and second is based on Transmission Path Loss, then you can easily solve these two questions. Let us solve first question over here. So here in first question, what is given you see? In the satellite communication system, the height of satellite is 36,000 km. So here distance in between two antenna is given, that is 36,000 km. Above earth and operates at 4000 megahertz. So frequency is given, that is 4000 megahertz. The gain of transmitting antenna is 20 dB. So gain of transmitting antenna, that is given 20 dB. And that of receiving antenna is 40 dB. So receiving antenna gain is also given, that is 40 dB. Find free space transmission loss. That is the first question. See, in my last video, I have explained free space transmission loss. You see, free space transmission loss is 32.44 plus 20 log distance in terms of kilometer plus 20 log frequency in terms of megahertz. So using this equation, we can easily solve free space transmission loss, right? So let me solve it step by step. See, free space transmission loss, that is 32.44 plus 20 log of distance in terms of kilometer plus 20 log of frequency in terms of megahertz. Here we just need to solve this equation where distance in terms of kilometer, that is 36,000 plus 20 log of frequency in terms of megahertz, that is 4000 here. Just solve this in calculator, you will be getting your answer. Let me check my answer over here. That is 195.6 dB. If any error is there, then just note it down over here, right? So that is how one can calculate free space transmission loss. Now second question is to find power received when transmitted power is 200 watt. So here transmitted power is given. In that situation, power received, that we need to find. So here we will be using Friis transmission equation, right? So in Friis transmission equation, I have derived that equation in my last video. See, that is received power divided by transmitted power, that is equals to GT GR divided by 4 pi D by lambda whole square. Here we need to find received power, right? So you need to make this term in form of received power, that is GT GR, and this transmitted power will come here, divided by 4 pi d by lambda whole square. Now we need to substitute values. So here if you observe, see, GT GR, that is given in terms of dB. So 20 dB is given. See, 20 dB means 100, 10 dB means 10, 20 dB means 100, 30 dB means 1000, 40 dB means 10,000, that is how values are there, directly one can calculate it, right? So 20 dB means 100 over here in value, 40 dB means 10 to the power 4 means 10,000, that you can say. So here we have GT GR, GT is 100, GR, that is 10,000, and PT, that is given over here, you see, as if transmitted power is 200 watt. So here it is 200 divided by 4 pi D, where D is 36,000 kilometer. So we need to have that in terms of meter in this equation, right? So 36,000 means 3.6. And here you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 fractionals are there, and kilometer, that is 10 to the power 3. So 4 plus 3 means 10 to the power 7 divided by lambda. See, lambda, that one can calculate from frequency. Here we have frequency, so lambda will be C by F. C is 3 into 10 to the power 8, frequency is 4000, so 4 into 10 to the power 9. So 3 by 4, that is 0.75 into 10 to the power minus 1 means 0.075 meter, that you can say. So we just need to substitute these values, 0.075 and this square. Just solve this in calculator, you will be getting received power over here. Let me check my answer over here. My answer over here is 5.49 into 10 to the power minus 12. Right, 5.49 into 10 to the power minus 12 means you can say it is 5.49 picowatt. Right, that is how simply we can solve this type of questions. Let us solve second question now. See, in second question, what is given? In second question, two planes 50 kilometer apart are in radio communication. So here distance between two antenna is given. Distance between two antenna is distance between two planes, right? So that is 50 kilometer, that is given to us. The transmitting plane delivers 2000 watt. So transmitted power is given, that is 2000 watt with 3 gigahertz operating frequency. So frequency is 3 gigahertz, right? You can say it is 3 into 10 to the power 9 hertz. Its antenna gain is 40. So here transmitted plane's antenna, that is having gain GD, that is 4040 over here in the direction of other plane. The power absorbed by receiving antenna of second plane is 1 microwatt. So here received power is given, that is 1 micro means 1 into 10 to the power minus 6 watt. Calculate effective aperture of receiving antenna. So we need to find effective aperture of receiving antenna. So first of all, you need to identify receiving antenna's gain. Based on that, one can calculate it, right? To calculate receiving antenna's gain, you need to know Friis transmission equation, that is received power divided by transmitted power is equals to GT GR divided by 4 pi D by lambda whole square. From this, you can identify GR. GR is how much? You just do cross multiplication. So PR by PT, and this will go in numerator over here. And this GT, that is getting divided over here. Now we need to solve this first to get GR value. So here we have values given to us. You see, PR, that is 1 micro means 10 to the power minus 6. PT is 2000 over here. 4 pi d by lambda whole square. So here 4 pi d is 50 kilometer. So 50 into 10 to the power 3 divided by lambda. Lambda can be calculated over here based on frequency. So lambda is C by F. C is 3 into 10 to the power 8. F is 3 into 10 to the power 9. So this will be 0.1 meter. So lambda is 0.1 meter, right? Divided by GT, GT is 40, that is given to us. So based on this calculation, one can have gain of receiving antenna, right? Let me check my answer over here for receiving antenna gain. That is 493.5, right? You should be precise when you use calculator. It is 493.5. Now based on gain of receiving antenna, one can calculate effective area. See, gain is equals to gain of receiving antenna is equals to 4 pi effective area divided by lambda square. So based on that, one can calculate effective aperture. So effective aperture of receiving antenna is gr into lambda square divided by 4 pi. We just need to substitute values, right? Gr is 493.5 lambda square, that is 0.1 square divided by 4 pi, right? Just solve this in calculator, you will be getting effective aperture. Let me check my answer over here. That is 0.39 meter square. See, that is how simply one can solve questions based on Friis transmission equations. So you need to be precise when you use calculator. Secondly, always remember, when you calculate this, at that time just convert things in terms of proper units first, right? And as and when you calculate this free space loss, at that time you need to be precise when you calculate things in terms of dB, right? So based on equations, one can easily solve this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.